Hi, hello, welcome back to another topic. So, our topic is Mendel and his experiment, that is monohybrid and dihybrid. Gregor John Mendel, he was a scientist and he began an experiment of a series of breeding experiment with garden pea plant, that is Pisum sativum, is an attempt of heredity. As an outcome of her experiment, he discovered fundamental principles of genetics. So we are moving to that experiment. So coming to the features of garden pea plant, there are so many features for the garden pea plant. So he used to select Pisum sativum, that is garden pea plant. So coming to the features, the pea flowers have both female and male parts, that is stamens and carpel. Many varieties of pea plants which carry out self-pollination. It can be easily grown. It have short life cycle or short cycle. Pollination can easily controlled. So he took an experiment with several characteristics for this green garden pea plant. First he removed the stamen from the purple flower, and purple flower means what? The carpels from the female and the stamen from the male. So he transferred the pollen from the stamen of the white flower to the carpel of the purple flower. So then parental generation, then pollinated carpel matured into pods, and fourth step, the planted seeds from pods, and the first generation of offsprings are formed. And these are the the third one is he examined the offsprings of all the purple flowers. So these are the series of steps done by the scientist. Fun pair of contrasting characters to cross fertilize, that is example, tall plants was allowed to be cross fertilized with a dwarf plant. The F1 generation, a result of the parental cross, appeared in the first generation. The F2 generation, the plant of the F1 generations were allowed to the self-pollinate produced F2 generation. In the F2 generation, he observed tall and dwarf plant in the ratio 3:1. This breeding experiment involved a pair of contrasting characters are called as monohybrid experiment. So one pair of contrasting characters to cross fertilize, that means he crossed the tall plant and dwarf plant and occurs of F1 generations, and this F1 generation resulting the characters of the cross between the parents, that is tall and dwarf. And coming to the F2 generation, the F1 generations is allowed to self-pollination, and which produce the F2 generation. And the F2 generations, he observed that the tall and dwarf are occurred in the ratio 3:1. So this breeding experiment involved a pair of contrasting characters called as monohybrid experiment. So in this experiment, he observed a pair of contrasting characters which is called as monohybrid experiment. So these are the steps, or these are the experiments done in the tall and dwarf plant. Breeding experiment involving two pairs of contrasting characters is termed as dihybrid. So the experiment or the breeding experiment have been done with two pair of contrasting characters. It is termed as dihybrid, whereas the pair of three or contrasting characters at a time, it is referred as trihybrid. Three or more, it is a polyhybrid experiment. So these are the characters of the pea plants in Mendel's experiment, that is seed shape, seed color, pod shape, pod color, flower location, and the plant size. Coming to the conclusion, the hereditary characters is the result of some unknown factors that determine the presence of trait. The factors exist in paired form. One member of the pair coming from one parent, the other coming from the other parent. These characters or these factors must be physical particles that remain intact throughout fertilization. Factors in each pair separates or segregate during the formation of germ cells or gametes, so that each gamete receives only one factor. So he discussed that there is a hereditary characters some unknown factors which determine the presence of trait or a character, and also these characters exist in paired form, one member from the one parent and other from the other parents, that is from a male and the female parents. And the factors must be what form physical particles with throughout the fertilization. And also these are factors in each pair, these factors are separate or segregate because they forms they aggregate during the formation of germ cells or gametes, so that the gametes receive only one factor, which is either from male and the female domain and the recessive. One of the two factors which are responsible for the pair of contrasting characters, one is domain over the other, which is referred as recessive, as we talk in the above statement. So there is two factors, but one is contrasting, only one is dominant characters and over the other, which is referred as recessive. So the result of this experiment was published in 1866 in the paper entitled Experiments of Plant Hybrid. Those classic experiments and the conclusions he drew from them whether later become known as Mendelism. Based on this experiment, Mendel postulated the laws of segregation and the law of independent assortment. His significant contributions to understanding of heredity. Mendel is regarded as a father of genetics. So the Johann Mendel or George Johann Mendel is a father of genetics, and he postulate the law of segregations and law of independent, and this experiment was published in 1866 in a paper entitled Experiment on Plant Hybrid, and later it comes as Mendelism. Coming to the monohybrid experiment, in the initial state of experiment, Mendel contrasted only a pattern of inheritance of single pair of contrasting characters. So he used only a single pair of contrasting characters. In this patterns of inheritance involving only one pair of contrasting characters is called as monohybrid. So we discussed that only one pair, it is called as monohybrid inheritance. In this first set of experiment, Mendel conducted cross pollination between pure breeding tall plant and pure breeding dwarf plant. So he crossed between the tall plant and the dwarf plant, pure breeding tall and dwarf. He collected the seed from this cross-pollination and allowed them to germinate. All the resulting plants were found to be tall. So, the net result or the F1 generation. So, the net result is all the plants are found to be tall. The F1 generations was allowed to self-fertilize and observe the F2 plants. So, the F1 generation is occurred, that is all about tall, and the F1 generation is allowed to self-pollination, self-fertilize and occur F2 plants in the ratio 3:1, which means 3 tall and 1 dwarf. This 3:1 ratio obtained in the F2 generation when only one pair contrasting characters are observed or considered in the cross is called as monohybrid ratio. So only we considered the one pair of contrasting characters, so it is called as monohybrid ratio, that is 3:1. Based on this result, Mendel came to a conclusion that in a cross involving two contrasting characters, only one character expresses itself into the next generation. So, from this result, from this experiment, he got a result that in the crossing, the contrasting characters, only one character will express in itself in the next generation. Mendel called the characters which expressed as dominant factors. So these characters, these expressed characters are called as dominant characters, and the characters which fail to express is called as recessive characters. And this idea came as the principle of dominancy, that is a first law. So the expressed characters, which means as dominant characters, and characters which are failed to express is called as recessive characters, and he came to the idea known as the principle of dominance, which is the first law. So the monohybrid ratio is 3:1. So these are the pictorial representation, the crossing over the parents, that is gametes T and T. And F1 generation is occurred, and F2 generation also, and the ratio will be the genotypic ratio of F2 generation is 1:2:1, and the phenotypic ratio is 3:1. Result of the Mendel single tree, that is monohybrid cross, the male parents and the female parent. F1 generation occurs as all produce round seeds. The plant grows and also allowed to self fertilization and occurs. F2 generation is occurred and in the ratio 3:1. The genotype and the phenotype resulting from various combination of gametes can be easily determined by Punnett square. Devised by C. Punnett. Hence, each of the possible gamete is placed in an individual column or row. Since the allele T is completely dominant, capital letter T is a completely dominant over the small t, a tall plant is obtained when at least one dominant allele is present. The both T and T and small t, capital T and small t genotype expressed as tall plant. In the total absence of dominant allele, which is capital letter T, resulting individual will be dwarf 1 and its genotype will be small t. These two different ratios are obtained in F2 generation. F2, the genotype ratio is 1:2:1 and the phenotypic ratio is 3:1. So for the combination of the various of the gametes for phenotype and genotype, they determine, or the C. Punnett scientist described or determined a Punnett square board, there is two different ratios are obtained for the F2 generation, that is genotypic ratio, which is 1:2:1, and the phenotypic ratio is 3:1. Coming to the needs of dihybrid crows. Mentell performed monohybrid crows for all the 7 traits independently and was able to differentiate between dominant and recessive form for each trait. He began to wonder that what would happen if he studied plants that differed in 2 traits. Steps of experiment are same as that of the monohybrid crows, but 2 characters and their alternative forms are considered simultaneously. So, what are the needs of a dihybrid crows? He performed with a monohybrid crows with all 7 traits independently, and there is a differentiate between dominant and recessive in each trait, and he began to study about the different 2 traits. And he step up an experiment same as with the monohybrid crows, and there's an alternative forms between 2 characters. Dihybrid crows, 2 parental plants are taken. The male plant will tall with a red or purple color flower having capital letter R alleles, and the female plants was dwarf with a white flower having small letter R alleles. So for the dihybrid crows, the parental plant, the male plant with a red or purple color, the female plant with a dwarf with white flowers. Coming to the dihybrid crows, Mentell performed monohybrid crows for all 7 traits independently and was able to differentiate between dominant and recessive from each trait. So we early talked about that the Mentell performed the monohybrid crows with 7 independent traits and differentiate between dominant and recessive for each trait, and he was then interested to know whether inheritance of 2 characters are influenced by each other or are inherited independently. Dihybrid crows is a crows when at a time 2 traits and their alternative forms are considered during hybridization experiment. So he considered the alternative forms are considered during the hybridization experiment. Steps of experiments are same as that of the monohybrid crows, but 2 characters and their alternative forms are considered simultaneously. Dihybrid crows, homozygous tall plant bearing a red flower, are crossed with homozygous dwarf female plant bearing with white flowers. So as the same steps are also taken in the dihybrid crows, which there is only a difference between monohybrid crows and the dihybrid. There is a 2 characters and their alternative forms are considered simultaneously. The dihybrid homozygous tall male bearing red flower and crossed with the homozygous dwarf plant with the white flower. So these are the pictorial representation of genetic expression of dihybrid crows. The parents, the F1 generation, and the F2 generations, which are noted in the Punnett square board. So these are the parents, these are the gametes. F1 generation is obtained or occurred, and the F2 generations are also formed. The F2 generation, 16 possible combinations are occurred. The tall red, tall white, dwarf red and dwarf white are in the ratio 9:3:3:1. The dihybrid phenotypic ratio is 9:3:3:1. and the dihybrid genotypic ratio is 1:2:2:4:1:2:1:2:1. So the phenotypic ratio is 9:3:3:1, and there is a genotypic ratio. So in the F2 generations, there are about 16 possible combinations are there, which means the tall red, tall white, dwarf red and dwarf white. Their numbers are given. These are all for this in the slide. Thank you all. We will meet with next topic. Bye.